2023, a year that will be remembered for relentless rains and frequent flooding.
We saw about 100 flash flood events in the state of New Hampshire in 2023. Over the last preceding decade, we had about 150 total.
While that may have been a fluke year, 2023 could potentially be a sign of future changes to precipitation patterns. A warmer climate could lead to more frequent and intense rainfall in New England.
There was this feedback loop where the wet pattern we were in just kept feeding itself over and over.
Sarah Jamieson is a hydrologist with the National Weather Service office in Gray, Maine. She says last year's intense rainfall and floods were part of a weather pattern that resulted from a stronger summer El Nino.
If we look at 2023 in isolation, a lot of the credit or blame needs to go to El Nino. But we can't ignore the influence of warming climate.
The Pemigewasset River here in Plymouth is one of many New England rivers that were hit hard by recent floods. Scientists are studying the changes along these rivers and how it could impact communities along them.
In order to keep track of ever-changing water conditions,
here we are at the Pemigewasset River at Plymouth Stream Gauge.
Rick Kaya and his team from the New England Water Science Center take measurements from 60 gauges at rivers across New Hampshire. These measurements include river height and stream flow, a measure of how much water is moving over a particular area.
We relay that through the GO satellite system in real time, so our other federal partners, like the Weather Service, can capture that data and do forecasts.
That data is then studied by Rob Dudley, who has investigated climate-related trends in New England's watersheds for more than two decades.
We've definitely seen trends in increasing precipitation. On the whole, we really have been seeing larger magnitudes in those frequent floods.
According to Climate Central, the Northeast has seen, on average, about a 60% increase in heavy precipitation since the late 1950s. Along with rainfall, temperatures also play a big role in changing river conditions.
And we have been seeing later ice formation and then earlier ice off on the rivers.
Winter is the fastest warming season in New Hampshire. Dudley says this is likely to have an impact on how rivers flood in the future.
With less ice, expectation is that there's fewer ice jams that would be contributing to flooding. And yet you have more rain on snow events.
While the increase in flood events is not expected to make flooding worse, it could increase the rate of erosion.
You get a change in the flow regime and the water is transporting and depositing sediments. And if the character of that is changing over time, it certainly is going to have some effects on the shape and function of the river.
And that is a concern for the many homes and businesses along our waterways. Some Granite State rivers have records that date back more than a century. Having such a long record of information helps scientists determine the conditions needed for a future major flooding event.
With the historic record that we collect, we can fine-tune what that flood level is, and then that will translate to our flood insurance rate maps to help with sustainable building in the future.
The data collected here and all across New England will help forecasters better manage the increase in flooding events. The next step, building resilience for vulnerable communities. In Plymouth, I'm meteorologist Matt Honig, WMUR News 9.